Continuing on to episode 3. Let's see what we got this time. Day 8. Yeah. Entire week later. A late night. Something tells me I'll regret that. Call from school. Oh, I better be okay. Why is it... That's a... I don't know how long it was. Well, yeah, buddy. They go back to work place and didn't agree to these. We'll go next weekend. Please just let me go to work. A permission slip? Why am I saying a permission slip? Something tells me I just fucked up something. Hmm. looks like a fucking Illuminati thing. I like the closure code. What happened? Is it because I chose the story mode? Am I? We finally get to the freaking gameplay that I wanted to get to. Tempest. Oh boy. Why is everything gray?
Good evening, Alex. It's Bozeman here, your boss. While you're powering up and getting the adverts loaded, I thought I should just tell you that we've had one of those public information films from the government, and it's mandatory that you play it. You still have a free choice for the other two, so read those tape labels carefully, but make sure you play the advance advert, preferably at the second break. Right, that's the lot. Have a great show.
Steve, why are all men such pricks?
That well, eh?
Apparently he has a complicated relationship with his friend.
No.
Sorry, are you saying he chose his imaginary friend in the sky over you?
I don't know why I talked to you.
You're probably just a really awful date.
10 seconds, everybody. Like I said, all of you.
Did your personality accidentally slip out?
Pricks. Going in 5, 4, 3.
Good evening. I'm Jeremy Donaldson.
And I'm Megan Wolfe. Our main stories tonight.
Uncooperative. A mysterious symbol has appeared overnight on thousands of buildings throughout the capital.
Tonight, in an exclusive live interview with Prime Ministers Julia Salisbury and Peter Clement, I'll be asking what this mysterious symbol might mean.
Critics have been quick to dismiss the graffiti as a publicity stunt, or an act of frustration by a tiny disorganized group of those who will never, under any circumstances, be content.
We shall overcome. Trapped in Dante's taint for more than a month now, Doctors Ingrid Svorsborg and Horgensbord and David Wong announced today that they're considering two possible options.
With two of the finest minds in science working together, hopes are still high for the eventual return of the team to dry land.
While both options are still on the table, support seems to be growing for a daring escape attempt. If a group of fungus experts can't fix the most advanced craft ever conceived by man, then who can?
Bearing their opinions, the fully rich are fighting back with a naked protest.
Our very own Robin Short was on hand earlier today when this new protest group first presented them.
Oh, what the fuck? What just happened? It just crashed! Fucking hell, it just crashed on me! What just happened? Okay. Oh, it's really, I don't know if.
Good evening. I'm Megan Wolfe.
And I'm Jeremy Dawes. Our main headlines tonight.
Okay. I'm gonna keep my fingers away from the 1, 2, 3, 4 thing because that's right next to like some of that stuff. I'm just gonna keep my finger on.
Saying he chose his imaginary friend in the sky over you.
I don't know why I talked to you.
You're probably just a really awful date.
10 seconds, everybody. Like I said, all of you.
Did your personality accidentally slip out?
Pricks. Going in 5, 4, 3.
Good evening. I'm Jeremy Donaldson.
And I'm Megan Wolfe. Our main stories tonight.
Uncooperative. A mysterious symbol has appeared overnight on thousands of buildings throughout the capital.
Tonight, in an exclusive live interview with Prime Ministers Julia Salisbury and Peter Clement, I'll be asking what this mysterious symbol might mean.
Critics have been quick to dismiss the graffiti as a publicity stunt or an act of frustration by a tiny disorganized group of those who will never, under any circumstances, be content.
We shall overcome. Trapped in Dante's taint for more than a month now, doctors Ingrid Svorsborg and Haugensbord and David Wong announced today that they're considering two possible options.
With two of the finest minds in science working together, hopes are still high for the eventual return of the team to dry land.
While both options are still on the table, support seems to be growing for a daring escape attempt. If a group of fungus experts can't fix the most advanced craft ever conceived by man, then who can?
Bearing their opinions, the formerly rich are fighting back with a naked protest.
Our very own Robin Short was on hand earlier today when this new protest group first presented themselves.
It might seem amusing to us, but clearly this formerly overprivileged section of our society is not adjusting well to the new future. It's often too easy to forget that not every citizen is thriving under advance.
Table for two. Johnny Hamsleys and Tiffany L'Amour were spotted having a private moment out at lunch today.
The popular couple have certainly been on a roller coaster since they started dating late last year. And this image is sure to place them firmly back in the tabloids.
Could we be on the verge of the biggest celebrity wedding since professional wrestler Randy Grizzlenuts McFridge married his longtime tag team partner Tina Tiny Hams last year in a wrestling ring made entirely of cake?
Is this one celebrated role model about to become the bad boy of sport?
And onwards and upwards. In an attempt to put the Mr. Snuggle Hugs disaster behind them, Rimmington's Fist CEO, Sophia Rimmington, today announced a brand new product that already has the markets buzzing with interest.
This groundbreaking product came as quite a shock when it was revealed earlier today, though its critics are skeptical that the young CEO can fulfill her promises.
Described as a breakthrough far ahead of its time, the male contraceptive pill is heralding a sexual revolution. Its fans are celebrating the fact that men can finally take equal responsibility for contraception. But others have expressed concerns over its safety and side effects.
With that exclusive Prime Ministerial interview coming up later.
And our very own Patrick Bannon coming to you live from the first annual Sports Board final.
You won't want to miss a second of tonight's
National Nightly News. By Mr. Snugglehugs, we have an exclusive interview with one of the victims.
Poor 7-year-old Timmy Tadlock, like so many of those affected by the Christmas bloodbath, has spent the last 3 months undergoing a series of reconstructive facial surgeries.
Last week, joyfully, he spoke for the first time since the tragedy. Tonight, he talks to us.
Before we go to the interview, however, this station would like to issue a full and frank apology for any part we may have played in the tragedy. We should never have advertised Mr. Snugglehugs. That our publicity, the sheer scale of this tragedy, now upwards of 8,000 casualties, might have been averted.
On behalf of the Nightly News team, we're sorry.
In future, we will do better.
Now it's over to Robin Short at the Tadlock family home. Robin?
Thank you, Megan. I'm here with Mr. and Mrs. Tadlock and their 7-year-old son, Timothy. Thanks for spending time with us today.
Yes, well, you're bloody lucky we're spending any time with you at all. After what you lot did. Irresponsible. I mean, whose idea was this anyway?
It's all right. It wasn't your fault. As you can see, Megan, there's still a few open wounds here. I'll tread carefully. I'm going to speak to Timmy now. Hello, Timmy. Can you see me?
Mummy? Who's that lady?
It's the lady from television, Timothy. She's going to ask you a few questions.
Oh, you be careful now, it upsets him to remember.
Don't worry, Mr. Tadlock. I wasn't the youngest ever editor of the Swinstead Middle School Inquirer for no reason. So, Timmy, can you tell us what happened to you? You had just unwrapped Mr. Snugglehugs, hadn't you? Was he under the tree?
Yes. I could smell him already.
Oh, she's a fucking idiot.
Yes, that'll be the fur. Scented with hoof.
I was so excited. I ran up to my room and gave him a big hug. He was so soft and warm, like our cat, before he got in the way of Daddy's Porsche.
Bloody cat had a death wish.
And what did Mr. Snugglehug say to you?
He blinked his real action eyes and said, "You're my very best friend." But I sure wish Mrs. Snugglehugs was here, and she can't be, for just $89.99. And then it's a general error. 41!
And is that when he burst into flames?
You're careful.
And then he exploded.
Oh, look, I've asked you nicely.
And am I right in saying that one of his real action eyes is now permanently embedded in your cheek?
Yes. When I took him in at night, it glows through bandages. I know it's under there, staring at me.
Yeah, some of the other children have started calling him Timmy Three Eyes. And then with his glasses, that's five.
It's too many eyes, Robin.
And what's the last thing you remember before the darkness overtook you?
He looked at me with his one eye and laughed. Laughed as he burned.
It sounds very traumatic.
You just brought up a child.
Right, that's quite
you,
enough of
Timmy?
You two coming in here with your camera trying to make a buck out of our suffering. I won't have it.
Mr. Tangle, just a couple more questions. Timmy, do you think you will ever be what we call
normal
again?
You've had your questions, and now look. Oh, you've made him cry with all three of his eyes.
Calm down, your skin. Do you think your parents
did
will ever really
Marjorie.
Love you again?
Right, that's it. Enough. Come on,
I'm happy,
Mr.
Tangle.
No.
So there you have it, Megan. Just one of the many victims of an indescribable tragedy that has shaken our nation. Thank you, Robin.
Many questions to be answered by Sophia Remington in the coming days and months, I'd wait.
Oh, she's about to get her ass kicked.
So, Jeremy, what are the warning signs a consumer should look out for when they're spotting a dangerous toy?
Well, Megan, experts advise to always check for the new Advanced Mark, which guarantee a level of safety and quality.
Yeah, can we just get a close-up on camera three here? So if we take a look at this National Nightly News mug, you should see the mark just on the base of it there.
In the wake of the scandal, the government were praised for their swift response in bringing in this set of stringent checks and new products.
It certainly is good to know that someone's watching out for our families. When we come back, our very own Patrick Bannon will be live from the Sports Board Finals. Stick around, you won't want to miss it.
We'll be back after these messages.
1 minute back.
Oh, sorry, I'm bursting.
Oh! She's very good.
Hmm.
Megan.
Yes, she is.
Watch your back, Jeremy. The women are coming.
I'm more worried about this water dripping into my head.
Alex, Bolton, we're getting reports in that naked protesters might try and spoil the Sports Board final by waving their fleshy bits about. Try and make sure you don't broadcast it. It's 6 p.m. for God's sake. No one wants to see fannies on the news. Bozeman out.
Yes, I understand that, but I always say welcome back.
I think we should just keep it as it is.
Well, of course you do. I've got one hack line.
What's that supposed to mean? I didn't write it, Jeremy.
That's all right, fine. Jenny, there's nothing wrong with the auto cue.
10 seconds.
Oh, I just felt a drip again. Have they not fixed this?
You want to see us fry? Good for the ratings.
5, 4, 3.
Welcome back to the National Nightly News. I'm Megan Wolf. Coming up later, we'll be speaking to the Prime Ministers about their exciting new healthcare facilities, transition centres.
Nice to see they care.
You're absolutely right, Jeremy. But first, We're going now to our own Patrick Bannon, who's reporting live from the finals of the new game that's gripping the nation. Sportsboard.
That's right, Megan, you joined me live here from the final of the first annual Sportsboard Championship. It's been a hotly contested competition so far. I think it's fair to say these two have been dancing around each other all season. First up, we have Ellie Stryker. She's the more experienced of our two players today. Stryker has got an accuracy of 7, a danger rating of K, and a 12-month driving ban. Stryker's known for her signature move, the Lanky Hamster. And facing her tonight, hoping to prove himself with a career record of 12 outs, 14 finishes, and a divorce pending, it's Mr. Wingspan himself, Tommy the Fingernail Harris. Just waiting on the ref now. The slapping ceremony is taking part. Still going on.
And, go first.
Stryker, of course, first to start, as she won the trivia round earlier on by some margin.
Deep robe.
Harris, perhaps the brawn and not the brain. Stupid. Ellie Stryker. Nice start there from Stryker. She's determined not to let the nerves show. Not after last time. On to Mr. Harris now. Tommy. Using his arm to pick up the ball. Not a bad shot there from Harris. Back to Stryker for shot number 3. All right. She's gone to sort of throwing it under her legs. Not bad, if you ask me.
To Harris.
Bit of business with the ref, but it got sorted out. Back to Harris now. A ball in the hand is worth 2 in the bush.
Football. Move back.
I'd say that's fair, but what do I know? Oh no, and Harris is not going to be happy with that. So really not a good start there for Tommy Harris in round one. We can only hope that round two treats him a bit better. But first, of course, after the argument with the ref section, it's time to change ends. Now we have the ceremonial changing of the ends. And of course, now they go back to the starting positions, as that makes sense. Stryker giving it large.
Second round, Dupley, Harris.
Winter round two now with Harris. Okay, we seem to have some sort of streaker on the pitch. I apologise if we broadcast any of that stuff. She appears to have slogans across her breasts and arse. Try and ignore all of that. Security, I'm sure we're going to take them out as soon as possible. Apologise if we broadcast any of that. As I said, we're going to get the situation resolved as soon as possible.
Nothing else.
They're trying to carry on play, but it's proving a bit difficult, and I'm struggling to follow.
Okay.
It's quite an eyesore, and women's body. Yeah. All right. Great. Okay. So back into round two now, and Harris absolutely determined to close that massive gap. Ellie Stryker. No, it's just some of the tightest play I've seen ever. Harris. And was that a fitted thumb screw? We haven't seen that since the Heat. What a brilliant move. Back to Stryker. And we know what that means, ladies and gentlemen. That is, of course, the ground sound. Excellent bit of play here on both sides of the bucket. I don't know about you at home, but I'm finding the technical mastery on display here absolutely blooming jaw-dropping. The ref has spotted something in Harris's neck or head. And Harris is having an absolute shocker. What a miserable start there for Tommy Harris. But he is a late bloomer, of course, always said that. And after all, it is a game of two halves. Four rounds and 7 subjects. But now, of course, it's time for the half-time show. Sponsored by Billington's Fish.
On my whistle.
Nice piece of music here to start the half-time show. Okay, another posh poker salute on the court here. We can only apologise for that. We'll do our best to shield you from having to look directly at it. He's running around here with his genitals on display for all to see. And ruining what was shaping up to be quite the dance interlude there. Now he's thrusting himself in Harris's face. Security's on it. And the bucket has been knocked over! I cannot stand it when the bucket gets knocked over. Hopefully he'll get taken out now. Genitals flying around for all to see. Really, if you ask me, not Sunday morning television. And out of there, hopefully taken away, never to be seen again.
Final pose. Oh boy, cannot be in the final pose.
And a lovely finish there on both sides of the bucket. I wouldn't like to call that one. And as we head into round three, I'd love to know what's going on in these two players' heads. But unfortunately, because of science, we can't.
Thank you, thank you, thank you.
Not bad. So that ball boy's giving me the eye all the day. I don't know what's going on. Striker there, not a great start. She looks a bit flustered, I think, after all that swinging around. Back to Harris here. God, what I wouldn't give to be that ball. I'm all right, ladies. Tommy Harris.
Tommy Harris.
And it dribbled down his arm, which is actually a really good move, because, of course, if it dribbles down his arm and goes on the floor, it's not going in the bucket. Back to Striker. And Striker's gone for the animal bonus there, but, of course, perhaps... And yes, Harrington's counting with a tiny bell. That is wonderful play. Of course, we've seen that before. Look at her face. She is absolutely gutted. What a mug. That could have been the clincher. What a massive shame.
Harris receives possession now.
Harris to serve now. Harris, of course, undefeated by Kestrel in his last four battles. So, here we go. Tommy Harris. That's all right. Not bad there. He threw it quite far away from him, which is quite a good idea. Very clever there. Perhaps a little contact. Caution from the referee, who's being, if you ask me, a little bit harsh. Ellie Striker. And she's let the nerves get to her. What the hell was that? You hate to see it, don't you? You cannot believe it. Oh, for God's sake. Okay, like, I mean, this is a mess now. I don't know what I can be doing about this. I mean, it's sort of breasts and genitals for all to see. I mean, there's only so much we can do. They're followed everywhere, aren't they? All right, I'll try and carry on. The players are trying to carry on, but of course it's difficult because these protesters are hoping we can get them taken off soon so we can carry on with the match.
Oh, hello!
What's going on here? Yes.
We want our money.
Yes, very good. Take them away.
Gambit.
Bloody wasters. Absolute wasters. Juggernaut!
This is the mine round.
It's an absolute bloody... Okay, and now we're going to go into the final round. And of course, as it's a Tuesday, the final round is a mine round. Who could believe it? Nice imaginary shot there from Harris. It really could go in here at this point. Really high-level play here from two absolute juggernauts of the sport.
Hold!
The bucket getting moved back to its proper place. About time, if you ask me. She's juggling it around from her hand. And she's put it in her mouth like as if it was an egg. And now she's... And she spat it out! She did the egg spit. So a wonderful move there, quite late on.
Illegal spit.
From Striker. But she's in it to win it. On it, like a car bonnet. Tommy Harris here, having a bit of beef. And he's peeling it as if it were a banana, which is an interesting move. Not sure if he hasn't had his potassium or what's going on today with Harris. And he's got it, and the banana was the ball! What a fantastic move there from Harris! Unfortunately, that is the end. What a pathetic, there we go, Jeremy, that is over. How can he look his eight-year-old son in the face tonight? What a lump! We just have to wait for the referee now to announce it to make sure it is all official.
Mm-hmm. Contestants in, please. And the winner of the first annual Sports Board Championship is...
Again, a win for everyone, including me. As my 15th win in the Sports Board Championship, I'm going to be celebrating tonight with my wife and children. Another wonderful victory for me. Here come the on-site security to collect their medals, their 6th and 7th respectively. And thanks again for watching the Sports Board Championships. What more is there to say? I'm Patrick Bannon, looking forward to celebrating tonight. And all I know is left to say, Jeremy, is back to you in the studio.
Patrick Bannon had an extraordinary final.
Historic sports board, Jeremy.
I didn't know you were a fan.
Oh, yeah, I can wrench a doubler with the best of them, I'll have you know.
I certainly wouldn't bet against you.
When we come back,
I'll be talking live with Prime Ministers Julia Salisbury and Peter Clement, who apparently have a big announcement you wouldn't want to miss.
That's coming up after these messages.
1 minute back.
Fucking microphone shot me.
What?
Fucking microphone just shot me. Where's that sound guy?
Everything okay?
Oh, the mics are just trying to kill us now, apparently.
You'll be fine. You're unshockable.
I'm immune to your cheap flattery.
I'm wearing you down.
Bozeman again. Just heard from the chaps in maintenance. The storm is laying havoc with the electrics, and you might notice the odd spark. Nothing to worry about. Happens all the time. Dave got shocked into a coma last year, but he was up and at 'em the next day. Anyway, our compensation package is parallel to none. Good luck. Bozeman out.
Sorry about Woody's buckets. We seem to have sprung a leak. Well, several, actually.
You're going to need a whole new lining up there.
We'll look into it. Minister, it's so good to see you again.
Miss Wolfe, your star seems to be in the ascendant.
It's a great time to be alive.
Too bloody right. Peter Clement.
Megan Wolfe.
My, but that's a firm handshake you've got there.
She's tougher than she looks.
Am I here?
Here, with Mr. Clement on your left.
Right you are, pet.
Your seat down.
10 seconds, everybody.
No, mine's fine. Have you had a little accident?
She's a coward.
5, 4, 3.
Welcome back. I am delighted to be joined by Prime Ministers Julia Salisbury and Peter Clement. Welcome to the National Nightly News, Prime Ministers.
Oh, please, it's just Julia and Peter.
We don't believe much in titles. It doesn't seem very advanced.
We're delighted to be here.
Well, firstly, I should ask how you feel about the graffiti that's been springing up across the capital. Should we be worried?
Oh, no. No, you definitely shouldn't be worried.
Well, not unless you've got a fatal paint allergy anyway.
But, yes, it does seem that there are still some people we haven't been able to help.
You know, whingers.
People who yet to benefit from the many advantages of the new future.
And you know, Megan, as my old mam used to say, there are some pissants who just don't know how to be happy.
We're working hard to reach these people, find out what they're angry about and how we can help. The door to my government is always open.
Someone's dripping on me.
But we didn't come here to talk about what may yet turn out to be some alternative arts project.
Which we no doubt will have funded.
When we want to talk to the nation about something far more exciting. Mm.
Yes, your office briefed us that you have an announcement to make, but they were being surprisingly secretive about it.
Let me ask you a question, Megan.
Okay, it's not usually how it works, but...
What scares you? I mean, really scares you?
It's death, Pet. She's talking about death.
We're all afraid of our deaths. It's part of being human.
Sorry, are you saying that advance have cured death?
That'd be a vote winner. Yep, that was definitely a drop there.
But while we may not have cured death, we hope we found a way to make it much less scary.
And much less painful, and much less expensive. Look, which is me close-up camera,
Ben? Oh, sorry, it's coming forward.
When I was 13, me mam came and got me from school. He had to go to the hospital. My granddad, he'd collapsed that morning, so we'd all to say our goodbyes. And I went in to see him, he was all frail and pale. I was scared because I'd only seen him the week before, and he'd been fit as fiddle. And he said to me, Petey, he said, it's the right time. I don't ever want to be a burden to the people I love.
Was that the last time you saw him?
Nope, 3 days later he was back home. He lived with us for 9 miserable years after that. He had to be fed with a rubber spoon. He had a commode, so he'd just take a shit right there in the lounge while we were watching football. He wouldn't even wait till half time.
That sounds...
It was awful. It were awful for us, and this is the point. It were awful for him. He could see it was destroying me, ma'am, watching him slowly fade away. And he would beg her to turn off his breathing equipment at night, but she couldn't. Or she wouldn't. It were a crime, you see. And she didn't want to lose the children as well as her old man.
No family should have to suffer like Peter's did. And now no family will have to. The health service is today opening the first of 300 new transition centres.
The transition centres will handle everything for your last days. The legal, financial, medical and emotional costs are all catered for and paid for by the government. So even the poorest citizen gets to pass on with dignity when they choose.
And that choice is important. This is a service only for people who choose it. For people who feel they run their course and don't want to burden themselves or their families with a slow, long, humiliating decline.
This mad phone package has given me an electric shock.
Are you okay?
I don't know. I flicking fried my arsehole.
Are you still on the air, Peter?
No, yes. Sorry. My apologies.
Are you not worried that this new system might be open to abuse?
In what way?
Sorry, I've got a sap to get. Can I get a little bit of help here, please?
That the older generation might feel somewhat...
Jesus, I'm wrong with your face, fucker! That one was massive! Right, no, this bastard's coming off!
That the older generation might feel somewhat coerced.
Coerced into spending their final days eating gourmet food and drinking fine wine and luxury spas and gardens.
Look, I am perfectly capable of that grandmother with a rusty twat.
Prime Minister, please watch your language.
Go get yourself sorted out.
Right.
We're launching a government information film tonight. It should tell your viewers everything they need to know.
You really do move at a breathless pace. It's hard to believe you've yet to be in office a year.
Oh, Megan, we're only getting started.
And on that note, thank you so much for being here. Jeremy.
Right, yes, that's all we have time for tonight. Our thank yous go out to our guests. Congratulations to all the winners at the Sports Award Final, and we'll see you tomorrow night at the same time. My name is Jeremy Donaldson. If you can, have a peaceful night.
And we're out. Good job, everybody.
Do you suffer? So they just...
The same thing.
I don't suppose there's any way this could be a good thing.
It's my nephew, so having transitioned, the moment I stopped the leak.
Come on. Oh, we got full A pluses. Hold on, I gotta see the rushes. Hold on. I'm sorry, I'm doing the last one because I want to hear all the shit.
So sorry about all these buckets. We seem to have sprung a leak. Well, several, actually.
You're going to need a whole new lining up there. Triple sealed, I shouldn't wonder.
We'll look into it.
Minister, it's so good to see you again.
Miss Wolf, your star seems to be in the ascendant.
It's a great time to be alive.
You're bloody right, Peter Clement.
Megan Wolf.
My, but that's a firm handshake you've got there.
She's tougher than she looks. Am I here?
Here, with Mr. Clement on your left.
Right you are, pet. Your sea dump.
10 seconds, everybody.
No, mine's fine. Have you had a little accident?
She's a cow.
5, 4, 3.
Welcome back. I am delighted to be joined by Prime Ministers Julia Salisbury and Peter Clement. Welcome to the National Nightly News, Prime Ministers.
Oh, please, it's just Julia and Peter.
We don't believe much in titles. It doesn't seem very advanced.
We're delighted to be here.
Well, firstly, I should ask how you feel about the graffiti that's been springing up across the capital. Should we be worried?
Oh, no. No, you definitely shouldn't be worried.
Well, not unless you've got a fatal paint allergy anyway.
But yes, it does seem that there are still some people we haven't been able to help.
Mm. You know, whingers mostly.
People who've yet to benefit from the many advantages of the new future.
And you know, Megan, as my old mum used to say, there are some pissants who just don't know how to be happy.
We're working hard to reach these people, find out what they're angry about and how we can help. The door to my government is always open.
Someone's dripping on me.
But we didn't come here to talk about what may yet turn out to be some alternative arts project.
Which we no doubt will have funded.
When we want to talk to the nation about something far more exciting.
Mm. Yes, your office briefed us that you have an announcement to make, but they were being surprisingly secretive about it.
Let me ask you a question, Megan.
Oh, okay, it's not usually how it works, but...
What scares you? I mean, really scares you?
It's death, pet. She's talking about death.
We're all afraid of our deaths. It's part of being human.
Sorry, are you saying that...
Yep, that was definitely...
That's why we may not have told death. We hope we found a way to make it much less scary and much less painful and much less expensive. Which is me called short camera. When I was 13, my man came and got me from school.
Sorry, my apologies. Oh. Nuts! Sorry, I got zapped again. Can I get a little bit of help here, please?
That the older generation might feel somewhat...
Jesus, a Rosio face, fucker! That one was massive! Right, no, this bastard's coming off!
That the older generation might feel somewhat coerced.
Coerced into spending their final days eating gourmet food and drinking fine wine and luxury spas and gardens.
Look, I am perfectly capable of... Oh, fuck! My grandmother with a rusty twat!
Prime Minister, please watch your language.
Fuck's sake!
Go get yourself sorted out.
Right.
We're launching a government information film tonight. It should tell your viewers everything they need to know.
You really do move at a breathless pace. It's hard to believe you've yet to be in office. Well, that's what it says.
Yes, I understand that, but I always...
...dancing around each other all season. Try and ignore all of that security. I'm sure we're going to take them out as soon as possible. Apologise if we broadcast any...